Formulas are one of the main features that make spreadsheets such as Microsoft Excel so powerful. With the use of formulas, you can change necessary data in multiple cells all at the same time by simply making cells dependent on a formula, which is dependent on data, or assumptions, entered into other cells. That may have been a confusing way to word it, but with practice, you will understand what I'm trying to say. In this tutorial, we will cover the most basic Excel formulas which will be necessary to know for our more advanced Excel tutorials. Entering formulas into Excel. To enter a formula into a cell, you will first have to use the equal sign. When the equal sign is the first bit of data entered into Excel, Excel immediately formats the cell as a formula. Therefore, Excel will try to solve anything you enter into the cell, and if you enter data that is not possible for Excel to solve, you'll get an error. For example, if you were to enter equals B, your result would be this, which is a name error. However, if you were to enter equals 5 plus 5, your result would be 10. The point is that if the first bit of data entered into a cell is the equal sign, then you need to enter a defined formula, unless, of course, you reformat the cell to text. Manually. Formulas almost always refer to other cells for their data. You can see in the example that we have added cells B4 through E4 by simply entering equals B4 plus C4 plus D4 plus E4 into the cell where we want our results to show. When we hit the Enter button on our keyboard, the cell will display a result of 44. If we change the numbers in any of those cells our formulas refer to, our result will change since they are dependent on those cells. The sum formula. In Excel, formulas are assigned a prefix. For example, if you enter equals SUM and then parentheses, Excel will find the sum of all the cells entered inside of the parentheses. Every cell inside the parentheses will need to be separated by a comma. If all the cells inside the parentheses are addressed right next to each other, then they can be selected together. For example, if you wanted to find the sum of cells B through E in row 4, you could enter equals sum and then inside parentheses B4 colon E4. Or you could enter equals sum and then parentheses B4 comma C4 comma D4 comma E4. And you would get the same result. The easiest way to enter the cells used in the sum formula is to select them with your mouse. Note, when using the sum formula, you could include a cell that does not have a numeric value, and the formula will simply find the sum of all cells which contain numeric values and formulas and will ignore the cells that hold text data. Autosum. Autosum is similar to the sum formula except that it automatically detects numeric values and formulas that are within the same row or column and automatically finds the sum. Autosum can be found on the ribbon under the formula tab. To use Autosum, all you have to do is activate the cell, click Autosum, and press Enter. Note, if you have already used a formula in the row or column, Autosum will only select the cells that follow the formula. However, if there are not any cells that contain data following the cell with the formula, AutoSum will still select all the previous cells in the row or column. Subtraction. Subtraction is fairly simple. The formula to enter into a cell is as follows: equals number 1 minus number 2 minus number 3. Here's an example. You can also perform subtraction in combination with the sum formula. For example, if you wanted to find out how much money you have left over at the end of the month, you would subtract the sum of your liabilities from the sum of your income. You can see in our example that we have subtracted the sum of cells D11 and E11 from the sum of cells B11 and C11. Multiplication. Doing multiplication manually. The multiplication sign in Excel is the asterisk. If you were to enter into a cell equals 5 asterisk 5, Excel would multiply 5 by 5 and show result of 25 after you pressed enter. The product formula. You can also use the product formula. To perform the product formula, you would enter equals product and then parentheses, and inside the parentheses, you would select all cells you would like to find the product of. Multiplication with addition. You can also combine multiplication with addition and subtraction. You would do this by combining the product formula with the sum formula, or by combining the product formula with subtraction. This would come in handy when making pro forma statements. Here, we have combined the sum formula with the product formula. Remember, the sum formula is equals sum, and inside the parentheses, number 1, comma, number 2, comma, and so on. In this example, we made number 1 the product of cells B17 and C17, and we made number 2 the product of cells D17 and E17. Multiplication with subtraction. Just like you use subtraction with the sum formula, you can also use subtraction with the product formula. In the example, we subtracted the product of cells D18 and E18 from the product of cells B18 and C18. Division. You can divide manually, but remember that the numbers will be divided in order from left to right. For example, number 1 will be divided by number 2, divided by number 3, and so on. The quotient formula. You can also use the quotient formula, but there are only 2 components to this formula. However, these components can consist of other formulas. With the quotient formula, the first number in the parentheses will be the numerator, and the second number will be the denominator. The formula is quotient, parentheses, numerator, comma, denominator. You can see that we've used a quotient formula to divide cell E23 by cell D23. Quotient formula with sum formula. Just as we combine the sum formula with the product formula, we can do the same with the sum formula and the quotient formula. Quotient formula with subtraction. Just like we combine the sum formula and the product formula with subtraction, we can do the same with the quotient formula. Parentheses and formulas. As you should now know, many different formulas can be combined in Excel. In fact, if formulas couldn't be combined, Excel wouldn't be the powerful tool that it is. However, if you don't use parentheses to separate different parts of a formula, you could make some major mistakes which would result in your worksheet being useless. You already know the order of operation, so this should be pretty easy to understand, but it can get confusing. First, take a look at this table and get familiar with the numbers in each cell. Suppose you wanted to multiply cells B29 and C29 and then wanted to divide the product of B29 and C29 by D29. Now, suppose you wanted to take the result of that calculation and multiply it by the sum of E29 and F29. Now let's say we wanted to divide our result from what we have done so far by cell G2. If we wanted to perform this in Excel, we would most definitely have to use parentheses. The point is that you need to treat each calculation separately, and you do this by using parentheses. Sometimes there are separate calculations within a larger calculation, as there are in this example. If you do this correctly, your answer will be 250. Carefully study what we did and practice it on your own. Conclusion. In this tutorial, we have covered how to use the most basic Excel formulas, different ways of performing each formula, combinations of Excel formulas, and how to use parentheses with formulas. Although you can accomplish a lot with the formulas you have learned, there is still a lot more to Excel. Open your own Excel worksheet and start playing with these formulas on your own. The best way to learn Excel is by practice in combination with these tutorials.